Okay, so alright, welcome to this video. So in this video, we'll be talking about electrical tools. So the common electrical tools that we are going to use if you are going to wire electrical system. No? So common, the common electrical tools. So first, we have the definition of a tool. So a tool is a device that can be used to produce an item or accomplish a task, but that is not consumed in the process. So meaning a tool, we will use a tool to do work, no, to accomplish a task or to do a job, but after the job has been done, that tool will not be consumed, no. So meaning we'll have the same amount or the same phase or the same number of tools that we have until we finish the work, no. So that is a tool. So it is different from a material, because a material is any device or anything that we use that is consumed, no, during the work. So after the work has been done, so a part or some amount of material will be used, no, and it will not be returned. Okay, so we have the types of electrical tools. So first we have hand tools. So are tools manipulated by hands without using electrical energy. So such as puller, hacksaw, purpose rule, pliers, hammer, and others. So hand tools, it is operated or manipulated by hand without any aid of electricity. So that is a hand tool, or those are hand tools. Then we have machine or power tools. So these are tools manipulated by our hands and with the use of electrical energy. So example of these are electric drill, grinding wheels, vacuum cleaner, and others. So machine tools, so they are still manipulated by hands, but compared to the hand tools, so the machine tools now utilizes electrical energy or electricity in order for the tools to work in its proper function. Okay, then we have the third type, which is pneumatic tools. Are tools or instrument activated by air pressure. Pneumatic tools are designed around these three basic devices: the air cylinder, the vane motor, and the sprayer. So pneumatic tools are any tools that is activated by air pressure, or the pressure, the air is coming from a compressor. So that's why we have the three basic design, no? Or the three basic devices that comprises a pneumatic tools. We have the air cylinder, so usually it is found on the air compressor, the vane motor, so the one who will pump the air, and the sprayer, or the one who will exert the air, so it will exert the air pressure. So for example, if you have a tool that is operated by air pressure, so the pressure of the air will operate the tool, or will make the tool work. So that is a pneumatic tool. Then the last one, the last type of electrical tool, is hydraulic tools. So are tools or instruments activated by fluid pressure. Example is hydraulic jack and hydraulic bender. So compared to pneumatic tools, so hydraulic tools uses or is activated by fluid pressure. So that is a hydraulic tool. Then we have the common electrical hand tools. So the first one is screwdrivers. Now, these tools are made of steel, hardened and tempered at the tip, used to loosen or tighten screws with slotted heads. So that is the purpose of a screwdriver. So it is made up of hardened steel, meaning the steel is hardened and tempered at the tip so that it could withstand exertion of force that will not make the tip broke, no, or break. Okay, so we have the different types of screwdrivers. So we have first the standard, the flat screwdriver. So the blade tip is wedge shaped and resembles a negative sign. So this is used to drive screws with a single slot head. So that is a standard screwdriver. So the tip is blade or wedge shaped and resembles a negative sign. So this screwdriver is used to unscrew a slot head, no, single slot head screwdriver. A screw, not screwdriver. Next, we have Phillips screwdriver. So this has a cross tip resembling a positive sign or cross. So it is used to drive screws with cross slot heads. So the Phillips screwdriver is 4 cross slot heads screw, no? Then we have the stubby screw, so it is has a shorter shank. So it comes in either standard or Phillips screwdriver with short shank or your blade and a shorted handle used to turn screws in tight space where standard screwdriver cannot be used. So that is for tight spaces, which is the purpose for a stubby screwdriver. Then we have the Allen screw or Allen wrench. So this is this could be in the shape of a screwdriver or a wrench. Its function is to drive screw with hexagonal slot head. So Allen wrench or Allen screwdriver is used for screws that has an hexagonal slot head. Okay. Then we have another common type of electrical hand tool is the hammer or the hammers. No, hammers are tools used in driving or pounding and pulling out nails. So they are made of hard steel, wood, plastic, or rubber. So we have these three common types of hammer that we are usually used in electrical work. So we have the claw hammer. So this is our claw hammer. Then we have also the mallet and the ball pin hammer. Okay. Then we have pliers. No, pliers. This made from metal with insulators in the handle and are used for cutting, twisting, bending, holding, and gripping wires and cables. So that is the most common use of pliers for cutting, twisting, bending, holding, and gripping of wires and cables. Okay, so we have the first type of pliers. We have the combination pliers, also known as lineman's pliers or the diagonal pliers. This is used for gripping, holding, and cutting electrical wires and cables and even some small nails. So they are usually used by linemen in doing heavy tasks. So this is the photo or the illustration of a combination pliers. Okay. Next, we have side cutting. So this type of pliers is used for cutting fine, medium, and big wires and cables. So that is a side cutting pliers. Then we have the long nose. So this is used for cutting and holding fine wires. This can reach tight space or small opening where other pliers cannot reach, and also used in making terminal loops of copper wire. So the uses of long nose ply is for tight spaces, no, or small opening which other types of pliers cannot reach, no, and also for making terminal loop, or if you want to have your copper wire shape in a loop, no. So that is those are the purpose of a long nose pliers, no. Okay. Then we have the wire stripper. So a tool used for removing insulation of medium size wires ranging from gauge number 10 to gauge 16. So this is used to remove the insulation or the covering of a wire, usually small wires from gauge 16, no, to gauge number 10. Okay. Then we have electrician's knife, no, sorry for that. So this is used by linemen to remove insulation of wire and cables in low and high voltage transmission lines. So this is the photo of a electrician's knife. It could also come in different sizes and appearance, no. Next, we have hacksaw. So this tool is used to cut metal conduit and armored cable. So for cutting metal conduit and armored cable, we will use the hacksaw. Then we have hand pipe bender. So it is used to bend pipes from 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch in size. So if we are going to bend metallic conduits, no, metal conduits in which the radius or the size is 1/4 to 1 inch, then we could use this hand pipe bender. Okay. Then you have also the torque wrench. So a tool used to apply precisely and specific torque to a fastener such as a nut or a bolt. So it is usually in the form of a socket wrench with special internal mechanism. So the purpose of torque wrench is to have a precise specific torque. So this is important because if we over compensate or if we over torque our bolt or nut, then it will cause the bolt to lose its thread or to break, no. So meaning we need to have or we need to have a specific torque, and we could set that one using our torque wrench. So that is to have a well torque bolt, no? So the torque is enough, no? Enough, so not too much, and not it is not also loosely torque, no? So because if it is loosely torque, or the bolt is not well tightened, it will cause also loss contact, especially on electrical terminals, no? So if you have a torque wrench, then we could have a precise torque so that our bolt and nuts are well tightened. Okay, next we have a knockout punch, no? Also known as a chassis punch or panel punch, Grinley punch, or a Q-max. So it's a hand tool used to punch a hole to sheet metal. Okay, so I hope I will not get flagged with the pronunciation. No? So sorry for the pronunciation. So usually it is used to bore or to create hole on metal sheets. No, so for example, in electrical works, it is usually used to make hole on the side of our electrical panel, or the bottom of the bottom or the top side of our electrical panel. So we have the knockout punch, no? Okay, so this is the knockout punch, no? This is the handle, these are the blades, these are the locking mechanism. Okay, next we have the wrenches, no? Wrenches are one of the most widely used hand tools. Their main purpose is holding and turning nuts, bolts, cups, screws, plugs, and various threaded parts. So the first type of wrench is the box wrench. So they are made in a long and short patterns with double offset and 15 degree angle offset. So when you say double offset, so each side of the wrench has an offset which is 15 degrees from the horizontal. So 12 point hex and square opening are available in regular and heavy duty patterns. So the pattern of the wrench itself, so it could be 12 point hex or square. Double head types have different openings in each head. So we have also double head types, so meaning this opening here is for different type of, or the different size of bolt. Then the other one also is for another size of bolt. So the ratcheting type has both hex and 12 point opening. So also the ratchet type, meaning it could easily be turned, no? So when you say ratchet type, so when you turn the wrench, you are not required to remove the hinge from the bolt, because it will just hold. Then once you return it, it will be also still turning to the to tighten or to loosen your bolt. The structural pattern is very similar to open end pattern, except that it has a 12 point box opening. Okay, then we proceed to open end wrench. So it is open end because as you can see in the illustration, the end is open. So we have different types now. So we have the engineer's, construction, structural, EVS, tapet, and set screw. Okay, so the most common here is the engineer's, no? So they are widely used and are made with openings at 15 degree angle. So the opening is 15 degree angle, which permits complete rotation of nuts with a 30 degree swing by flapping the wrench. So they are available in both single and double head pattern. Okay, so this is the double head pattern, then we have also the single, no? Okay, then we have the combination box and wrench. So these are widely used patterns, are made in long and short types, having a 15 degree angle open end, a 12 point box opening of the same size in the opposite. So the size of the opening are the same in both sides. The only difference is this one is a open end, the other side is a box end, no? The box opening is offset at 15 degree angle to the handle of for clearance. Okay, so the box has a 15 degree angle. Okay, Then we have the adjustable range. So are designed to provide a wide range of capacity in single tool and are a convenient service range for repairmen, linemen, and others. So they can loosen nuts of different size. So we just need to adjust this one, the roller here. So we will just adjust that one. No, they are available in lengths from 4 to 24 inches. So meaning we could. We will have a handle which is 24 or 4 inches. Okay. Then we have the plumb bob. So a plumb bob or a plummet is a weight usually with pointed tip on the bottom that is suspended from a string and are used as a vertical reference line or plumb line. So if we want to make our installations vertical, no, straight with respect to the floor, so we'll use a plumb bob. Okay. Then we have the prick punch. So it is used for making out some points in the material to be punched. It is also known as duct punch. So it has a sharper angled tip to produce a narrower and deeper point. So it is usually used to put an initial punch, no, or put an initial dot on concrete so that if we will use our electric drill, so the bit will not move around. So it will hold the bit on place so that we could put a precise hole on our concrete. No. Then we have file. So a file is a metal working, woodworking, and plastic working tool used to cut fine amounts of material from a workpiece. So we forgot an S on that part. No, it is most commonly refers to the hand tool style, which makes the form of a steel bar with a case hardened surface and a series of sharp parallel teeth. Most files have narrow pointed tongue at one end to which a handle can be fitted. The most common type of file is the flat file, which is a file with two flat surfaces, no, just like this one. So the round file, we have also another type which is the round file, are used to file small red dial or two enlarged walls. So the main purpose of file in electrical works is to file the end of our conduit so that the wire could not be stripped, no, or the covering of wire could not be stripped once we will put our wire inside the conduit, no. So if we have also cold chisel, so with exception of the blacksmith pattern, cold chisel will be made from round, square, hexagonal, or octagonal steel stock. The blacksmith cold chisel is fitted with a handle. So a cold chisel have a cutting edge at one end and for cutting, shaping and moving metals softer than the cutting edge itself, such as cast iron, wrought iron, steel, bronze, copper, etc., and a struck face on the opposite side. So usually a cold chisel is used to chip or to chip some concrete on our wall, especially if you are going to embed our conduit, no. Then we have C frame pipe cutter. So the C shape, this is the one, the frame. So the C-shaped frame cutter is made with a fed screw that causes the removable housing to slide forward, making with the pipe. It is commonly used to cut pipe. So we have here, this is the screw in which it will tighten this one will move, it will tighten. Then if we will put our pipe here, so the pipe will be held tight in this position, then we just rotate the handle. So this one here, the roller blades will cut the pipe as we turn it on its axis, no. So that is the C-frame pipe cutter. Then we have the pipe reamer. So if we are going to ream the pipes, no, usually we will use file, no, so that the wire will not be stripped. So just like what I said a while ago, but we could also use the pipe reamer. So the pipe reamer is much comfortable to use. So it is used to remove bore inside the pipe after cutting it using a pipe cutter. There are two types of reamer. The first one is the spiral reamer and the other is the straight flute reamer. The spiral reamer is commonly used to enlarge holes in conduit box or in the steel sheet metal application. So for conduit boxes and sheet metal, so we use this spiral, so this one. The straight flute is used to remove bore without enlarging the pipe's inner diameter. So this is the straight flute. Then we have here conduit bender. So this is the another definition of conduit bender or the handpipe bender. So they are the same. So the I used to bend conduits up to 90 degrees. So as you can see here, we have 90 degrees in here. So you can bend conduits up to 90 degrees. Okay. Then we have hickey or hickory. No, I believe it is much pronounced as hickey. Maybe we just edit this one. No. Okay. Just edit this one. So this is hickey, but not hickory. Okay. So we like having a natural rhyme, hickory hickory duck. No. So we just have that one as hickey. Okay. So hickey is a tool used to bend offset bends on conduit. So offset. So usually they are used to bend offset. No. Later in our discussion, we will have the different types of bend. No. Offset bends are sometimes hard to accomplish using a normal conduit bender, so a hickey must be used. So if you want to have an offset bend, we'll use a hickey. Next, I believe this will be the last tool that we are going to discuss. No, so hand tool. No, the vise. No, is sometimes called as the third hand and is used to hold firm material to be worked on. The commonly used vices are machinist vise and pipe vise. So machinist vices are designed to withstand the strain in industrial work and similar applications. They are usually available in jaw widths of 3 to 8 inches. So pipe vices are designed to hold round pipes. So this is a machinist vise, no, and this is a pipe vise. So we'll put our conduit here and we will cut. No, if you are going to have some metal works in which we are going to hold also the metals of flat bar or angle bar, then we will use the machinist vise. Okay, so I believe that will be all for this video. So I hope you understand the purpose, and also you can see the you have saw the appearance of our electrical hand tools. So in the next video, we will be discussing about different power tools we will use in installation of electrical system. So I hope you understand something in this video, and as always, enjoy learning.